Rumor has it that a Donkey Kong expansion is coming to Universal Studios Hollywood. Let's discuss on the why that may not be such a great idea if you look at operations-wise versus something other Nintendo-related. Let's discuss right here on Theme Park Wizard. Before we get started, I want to say thank you to all the members that signed up, the new channel members that signed up. If you are watching this early, then you are a channel member. It will be going out to the general public on a few days later. So if you're watching it on that time, thank you for watching and thank you for subscribing. Press that like button no matter who you are, and please share the video because this is very, very interesting. But yes, Super Nintendo World and Universal Studios Hollywood is doing extremely well. In fact, Comcast CEO Brian Roberts just came out on the earnings call on Thursday, April 27th, and said that Universal had such big attendance jumps, Universal Hollywood specifically had such big attendance jumps, that they're like above pre-pandemic levels, like above 2019 levels so far in terms of attendance, all thanks to Super Nintendo World. And that's obviously jumped, made record revenue, right, for the park. Also, if you see those merchandise sales, you've watched my weekly updates, you see all those empty shelves, hard to keep up with the merchandise at the Nintendo stores throughout the park. All that's leading to record revenue, and overall in the parks division had a 46% year-over-year increase in revenue, which is incredible. But then Nintendo World here in Hollywood and in Japan, since Japan's releasing COVID restrictions, more people are able to go to Super Nintendo World in Japan. Their attendance numbers are growing as well. So basically, it's Super Nintendo World lands are very popular, and the movie, of course, is nearing $1 billion. And by the time this comes out to the general public on Monday, this would have passed $1 billion already worldwide, becoming one of the biggest animated movies of all time. Super Nintendo World in Hollywood is only, what, maybe 3 acres or so, and that's of actual walking space. Add another 1 or 2 acres for the ride itself. It's not very big, much bigger than I thought it was going to be, like, in terms of the walking space, but it's still overall not very big. That is obviously one of the main complaints of it from theme park enthusiasts and the regular general public on the GSAT. You know, that's GSAT is guest satisfaction. Universal uses those surveys and reviews, and one of the basic complaints is it's just too small. Obviously, Universal Hollywood is a small park, but they have lots of room to expand via sound stages and different creative ways. Nintendo's expansion is coming, of course. It's been heavily rumored to be themed to Donkey Kong Country. The same Donkey Kong Country coming to Epic Universe is Super Nintendo World and Universal Japan's Super Nintendo World. But I'm here to ask, is that like such a good idea? And you guys know me, I'm a massive Nintendo fan, massive Nintendo World fan. I love this land. I've done extensive updates on the construction of land, and in those construction updates talked about how I'm super excited for Donkey Kong to come here. But as a capacity issue, I'm not so sure anymore. The lower lot, especially on sold-out days at the park, is very, very crowded, very hard to navigate. Now, Super Nintendo World itself is hard to navigate when it's very busy, and there's just queues everywhere for the games, the rides over an hour, usually over 2 to 3 hours most days, except on maybe weekdays. Just very, very busy. Toad's Cafe is really fully booked up every morning, even on slow days. Seems to be booked up by like 10, 11 a.m. every single morning because that's the only place to really eat there. It's just very popular. A Donkey Kong expansion, one of the problems with the Donkey Kong expansion, I guess really any Nintendo expansion, would be that there's, if built as currently planned, there'd be an entrance to the Donkey Kong land, but only through Super Nintendo World. So like in Japan, you can only go through a warp pipe from the Mushroom Kingdom into Donkey Kong. And as you see with the Epic Universe construction updates that we do, you can see that the same system. You only go through one warp pipe to get to the Mushroom Kingdom, Super Nintendo World. Then you go through a warp pipe to get to Donkey Kong Country. If it's already so busy to get into the Mushroom Kingdom here in Hollywood, imagine what it'd be like when you can only access Donkey Kong through Super Nintendo World through the same warp pipe. Whatever Nintendo expansion they proceed with here, either Donkey Kong or something else, I really do hope they amend that and make it multiple accessible ways, right? So I know it won't really break the immersion if you do the same type of war pipe situation that you do now, but Universal Hollywood really needs at least two ways from the low lots to get into whatever Nintendo expansion they do, especially if it becomes behind the sound stages, what the former voice sound stage was behind the current Super Nintendo World, because it's just too packed. Imagine that, like, there'll be never a reservation to get into Nintendo World because it'll be full the entire time. Propose they take out the Panda Express and the Studio Cafe and all that stuff over there, expand the current Mushroom Kingdom, maybe put a small little dark ride there exclusive to Hollywood, and of course put Donkey Kong as well, but with modifications. I heard that the Donkey Kong Minecart Madness, which is the rumor name for the Donkey Kong coaster, can only handle about 800 people per hour max. Max! That's when it's running completely efficiently. If you look at the Mario Kart Bowser Challenge attraction here in Hollywood, that at max capacity is about 1,300 people, but it has to be running perfectly. There can't be any seats just roped off because the goggles aren't working, which is a routine occurrence. The cast members have to bring full efficiency. There can't be any empty seats, which is very hard to achieve on a normal day. But they're still kind of getting used to it. The land's only been open officially for 2 months, so they're still kind of getting used to the operations of the ride. I actually asked a team member, actually my friend Vash Guy, who's been on the channel, he asked a team member how the operations were, and they said they, on good days, they can get to 1,000 people per hour. That's on good days. That means they're doing less than that most of the time. That is leading to those 2 to 3 hour waits, plus a long single rider line, and no guest complaints because they're waiting too long in a land that's too small. There's lots to do, but it's just so many people all at once. I'd hate them to make the same mistake with Donkey Kong. If the max capacity is around 800 people or so per hour, that's so little. Makes sense though, and I was wondering about that because the carts are just one car and 4 people per car. There can only be so many cars on the tracks at one time, so it does make sense it's around 800 people per hour. If Donkey Kong Country comes here to Hollywood, I'd suggest that they make the minecarts at least a little bigger. So instead of 4 people per car, maybe 6 to 8 people per car. Modify the cars a little bit. That way, the max capacity can maybe at least get to Mario Kart levels, like 1,000. You know, still not the greatest, but it's better, much better than 800 per hour. I'm not quite sure how many mini games are in the Donkey Kong Country expansion. There are at least 2 to 3, I believe, new additional mini games in that land. I think Hollywood should get a couple more, and actually another mini game or two inside Peach's Castle, because there's a lot of empty space there. There should be at least another mini experience or something. And again, if they take out the Studio Cafe and the Pan Express and all that stuff, they can put it like either Nintendo Dark Ride or more experiences, more walkthrough experiences there that some are missing from the Japan version. They can add those over there. But if we get Donkey Kong, they should add some more mini games or more experiences than what is currently in the Japan version. Just try to soak up some of those people. Want to help with any capacity issues, they can completely ditch Donkey Kong Country and still do a Nintendo expansion, but to a different IP, whether it's Zelda, but that may be that's probably too popular just for like a mini land. But Pokemon, Metroid, some other Nintendo IP that's popular, but not super popular that wants a massive land, but you know, takes off the capacity for Mushroom Kingdom, adds an immersive dark ride or roller coaster, family coaster, and adds some more mini games. Just something that has a higher capacity than 800 people per hour. But what do you guys think? What do you guys think of this situation? Do you not care? Do you like bring Donkey Kong in its current form no matter what? Do you think capacity could be an issue because that can affect crowding on the lower lot? They're going to have to at least make the lower lot, you know, bigger, right? The pathway, whether by demolishing Mummy or doing something, because the pathway is really tight as it is right now. Those of you who have been to Nintendo or seen videos know what I'm talking about. So how would you guys fix the potential capacity issue of the lower lot in general, and if they do a Donkey Kong expansion, especially one where you can only enter the new land through the existing Super Nintendo World? Let me know all that in the comments below. Subscribe for more theme park updates, and yes, I have a new, brand new, it's my third time, you know they say third time is a charm, with the membership system here. Tier 1 is $2.99. per month. That's like the cheapest possible price, so that at least I found. So trying to make it super cheap, but you can get some members only videos or member early member videos and member only videos and do some member live streams. Nice and affordable price. Trying to build a member community in here. So let me know what you guys think of that. And please become a member for some awesome new videos, early videos like this. And eventually, when the community gets big enough, some exclusive member videos. I hope you guys have a great time. Stay tuned for more Epic Universe updates, Universal Hollywood updates, and all theme parks around Southern California and Orlando. Like, subscribe, and have a Donkey Kong day.